To display a map in D3, we do not theoretically have to do anything much different from when we displayed points in a scatter plot. We simply need to convert from some data representation to a screen representation, or rather, go from the domain of our data to some range of pixels to draw on the web page. In the scatter plot, we went from years, represented as a date, and attendance, represented as floats, to pixel values, or rather, x-coordinate and y-coordinate on our chart. And for our map, we do exactly the same thing, except this time we're going from geographic coordinates to an associated pixel range. Or more specifically, we're going from a latitude and a longitude coordinate to pixel values. The latitude actually corresponds to the y-coordinate, and the longitude corresponds to the x-coordinate. In the scatter plot, we used D3's scale to go from our data domain to our pixel range. And in a very analogous way, to convert our geographic coordinates to a pixel range, we have to use a projection, or more specifically, in our case, we'll be using the Mercator projection. But let's take a second now and really understand what a projection is. Coordinate data that represents points on a sphere, or in our case, the globe, actually encodes information in three dimensions. And since the Earth, being a three-dimensional object or a sphere, there is no perfect way to display it on a two-dimensional surface, such as a computer screen or a piece of paper. One approach that you could take, and is often used out there, is to simply render a globe or a three-dimensional object in a web page using three-dimensional graphics. But this has its own set of complexities, in addition to the fact that you can usually only see one face of the globe at a time. The other, much more common approach is to use a projection, which actually has been done for centuries, to draw maps on parchment or canvas. The act of projection can be thought of as cutting the surface off of a three-dimensional object or globe and trying to flatten it out into two dimensions. And there's never a perfect way to represent something in greater dimensions in a lower dimension without some loss of information or distortion. So when you're going from a three-dimensional globe to a two-dimensional map, the question then becomes, where do we distort our map? And what's often done depends on the region of geographic interest. If you're only looking at countries on the equator, you want to try to best preserve the spatial representation around the equator, and you might be willing to distort near the poles. And the Mercator projection does just that. It decides to distort the least populated regions, or more simply, regions near the poles. To imagine this projection, think of trying to flatten this globe out, and in order to get a square, you stretch the areas near the poles so that the Earth can be represented by a rectangle, which also has the effect of straightening out the latitude and longitude lines. So the Mercator projection sacrifices the poles to preserve countries and areas closer to the equator, which have a much more accurate representation in two dimensions.